We've talked about the dot product or the scalar product. So in this video, I want to talk about the cross product or the vector product, because the cross product results in a vector. So let's start with two vectors. So we have the vector A, which is A1i plus A2j plus A3k. And we have the vector B, which is B1i plus B2j plus B3k. And I want to form the cross product of A cross B. The cross product is a vector, and it's quite a bit more complicated than the dot product. The way to remember what the vector is to use a 3x3 determinant. So what you do is you write this where the first row of the determinant is the unit vectors I, j, and k. The second row of the determinant are the components of A, so A1, A2, and A3. And the third row of the determinant is the components of B, so B1, B2, and B3. So this 3x3 determinant. And that's how you remember the cross product. You can compute the determinant. You can write it out in long form. So you eliminate the first column and the first row. So that will be multiplied by I. And then you get A2, B3 minus A3, B2. A2, B3 minus A3, B2. And that goes in that's the component along the x direction, multiplied by the I unit vector. The second one, you eliminate the second column and the first row. That one has a minus sign, so we end up with A3B1, so plus A3B1 minus A1B3, and that goes in the j direction. And then the k direction we get by eliminating the first row in the third column, and then we get A1, B2 minus A2, B1, and that goes in the k direction. Okay? So this somewhat complicated expression, which is just a 3x3 determinant, defines the cross product. Okay, there's a cross product satisfies certain properties similar to the dot product. The main difference here is that if we look at A cross B and commute A and B to B cross A, how does it change? Well, B cross A means we change the rows of this determinant. You may remember from the theory of determinants that when you interchange rows of a determinant, you change the sign. So this gets a minus sign. So A cross B is equal to minus B cross A. Okay. We can also look at a geometric definition of the cross product. So let's look at two vectors. So vector A, say, I'll draw it here, and a vector B, can draw it here. In order to figure out the cross product, we can impose a coordinate system on here. So I'm going to use the same trick I used for the dot product. I'm going to put the x-axis along A and the y-axis perpendicular. So as before, A here is going to be the magnitude of A times the I unit vector, and B is going to be the magnitude of B times the cosine of this angle, so the angle between A and B, the acute angle between A and B is theta. So it's the magnitude of B times the cosine of theta times I plus the magnitude of B times the sine of theta times J. Okay? Then we can compute A cross B. But in order to get a result which is independent of coordinate system, I'm going to compute the magnitude of A cross B. So what is the length of this vector? Okay? We can do it from the magnitude of this determinant, or else we have the expression here, so we might as well use it. Here, A2 and A3 are 0, so all we have is A1. And here, all we have is B1 and B2, so we only have the term with A1 and B1 and B2 in it, which is only single term, which is this one. Okay? So only one term in this expression. So the magnitude then is just going to be A1 times B2, which is going to be equal to the x component of A, which is the magnitude of A, times y component of B, which is the magnitude of B times sine theta. Okay? And this is a coordinate independent expression. So it doesn't matter how I defined the coordinate system here. A cross B magnitude, the length of A cross B, is just the length of A times the length of B times the angle between A and B, independent of coordinate system. So this is in general true. Okay, one thing missing. In which direction does A cross B point, okay, given A and B? To do that, we have something called the right-hand rule, R-I-G-H-T, hand rule, okay? The right-hand rule, you have to take your right hand, okay? You point your fingers in the direction of A to determine the direction of A cross B. You point your fingers of your right hand in the direction of A. You curl your fingers in the direction of B, and then you get the direction of A cross B, which will be coming towards you, okay? So the direction of A cross B is towards you when you use your right hand. So you should try that. You should lift up your right hand, put your fingers in the direction of A, curl your fingers in the direction of B, and then the thumb will point in the direction of A cross B. Okay, it should be towards you. One more comment that I would like to make. What happens if A and B are parallel? So if A and B are parallel, B is a constant times A, then theta equals 0 and sine theta equals 0. So if A is parallel to B, then A cross B equals 0. Okay? So that's a big difference between the cross product and the dot product. If A and B are perpendicular, then A dot B equals 0. But if A and B are parallel, then A cross B equals 0. Okay, so let me summarize. The cross product is sometimes called a vector product because the cross product gives you a vector. You can compute the cross product, A cross B, from this 3x3 determinant. That's how you remember the cross product. The magnitude of the cross product of A cross B is the length of A times the length of B times the sine of the angle between them. And finally, you need to use the right-hand rule to determine the direction of A cross B. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.